I did.
Well, my daughter, my seer, ordinary people like us are no match for her. What? You'll understand why I'm so worried when you see for yourself what it leaves behind. After we
landing there.
Yes, I saw them rushing in.
Why are the bugs swarming in like that?
Warning! This is the Great Corridor.
I'm completely ruined because at first I went around looking. The pile consisted of bone fragments. Everyone told me I should Queen Belandir. She ruined my life overnight. You mean the sandworm lair?
Glen Richhill wanted to dissuade his daughter from trying to hunt down Queen Belandir. He was well aware of the Queen's horror, given that he died after losing his leg to her. Having witnessed the aftermath of Queen Belandir's work in person, you could understand why he was so worried about his daughter that he was unable to leave this world.
Thank you.
Hurry it up!
Queen Belanda, I am Josephine Croft, a wizard from Venelux. I discovered that the magic used by Soren Warnack correlates with Queen Belanda's mana. So I've been invested.
Did you go looking for Queen Belanda on purpose? She has already taken so many resistance members from us.
Oh, I understand. I'd want to stop my family if they said.
I'm busy doing some maintenance at the moment, my friend. Maybe you can fly down to the observatory, if you can jump from that lofty hill there. You're not really going to try that, are you?
I've never seen you before. What brings you here? So what you're saying is that Queen Belandia is a monster that can't be beaten, and I should give up and stop trying. I don't know why a complete stranger like you is so concerned for my safety, but what do you think we're doing here? Everyone who's ever lived in this area has lost something precious because of Queen Belandia. We're fighting so that this tragedy finally ends. I've made a detailed plan.
The investigation team stumbled across Queen Belandia during their survey, leading her to launch a fierce attack. If it had not been for the wizard Josephine Croft, they might have failed to escape. You then sought out Marcia Richhill, Glenn's daughter and Sandworm Raid Group captain. You tried to persuade her to cease her plan to defeat Queen Belandia. However, she did not relent.
Hey.
When Glenn realized that he couldn't stop his daughter, he decided to help her. He recalled the trap Marcia had prepared and thought that if he could lure Queen Belandia there, his daughter could achieve her goal without being in danger. Perhaps the wizard Josephine can find a way to help Marcia.
We meet again. Ah, I see. If that is the intent of the raid. So, you mean to bait Queen Belandia to ensure the safety of the raid group, right? Oh, come to think of it. Clay wrote in one of his books that Queen Belandia. He also wrote, the potent sandworm poison sac can be utilized at with the potent sandworm poison sac. If that doesn't work, it's true that Queen Belandia's power. So you really didn't know. If someone with evil and. Let's try making a luring. You can easily find plenty of. First, make sure they're stunned by the trap before you go to kill them. Sandworms make stronger there is a resistance force that guards the-
Josephine recalled some passages in Clay's book, and found a way to lure Queen Belandia. She also informed you that the source of Queen Belandia's power was something known as a star fragment. Though star fragments contain pure power, someone created a monster called Queen Belandia out of evil intent. Queen Belandia's attraction to powerful mana to lure her in. Now, in order to create artificially powerful mana, you need to create a lure using Armadillo's sharp scales. Yeah.
you want to know more about Queen Balandir, I'm sure.
In the past, Silavian Order grant.
You can find bristled, a pristine bristle. You'll find potent poison cell.
The sandworm's poisons, not only can it...
You can get a glimpse of Clay's interest in the various monsters and poisons of Silesium through his books. These books contain interesting information, such as the fact that the mighty Queen Balandir was originally a small sandworm, and that sandworm poison sacs have the rare ability to detect another being's mana.
This is a sandworm hatchery. You're looking for poison sac? Good. Maybe you could shape good. I'll brief you. Now you can get hot. You can get what I need is a sandworm. I didn't expect to discover this precious thing. The shell is very fragile. Try not to damage it. What the? Help me!
The potent sandworm poison sac is also used as a raw material for mana production. It is particularly suitable for a mana amplifier to lure Queen Belandia, because it can be used to freely adjust the emitted level of mana based on external conditions.
Thank you.
You're back just
first. Put the failed. Elemental fusion stones are naturally. I'll prepare. Sand crystals are available.
The first attempt to build the device for luring Queen Belandia ended in failure. Since common elemental fusion stones often contain impurities, they cannot be used to contain delicate and complex schema, like the magic schema for attracting monsters. Josephine explained that making a pure elemental fusion, purified water used to draw a magic schema, is essential to making a pure elemental fusion stone. This is because low water purity can lead to errors in the schema. In the desert where water is scarce, cactus water can be used as a viable substitute.
When is he coming?
What? Monsters are swarming near the oasis!
waiting. Did you get the... We need to make it quickly, but this hardens it to complete the pure elemental fusion. Here we go. Afterward, the level of mana around the device will increase. Now, here's how to... Like I mentioned, I made the device for Queen Balandir will appear soon after pressing the button.
Having finished crafting the pure elemental fusion stone, the device for luring Queen Balandir was complete. After installing the device, you press the button of the remote control to amplify the mana emitted and attract Queen Balandir. The remote control must be operated at a minimum safe distance from the device.
What brings you here this time? We can lure Queen Balon. Most members of the ring. My troops are currently working. If you get out there and help them with them, everyone is bringing their very best. Read the operation plan.
Upon learning about the luring device, Marcia wanted to catch Queen Balandir immediately. However, in order to do so, a full-scale offensive involving the entire Sandworm raid group is needed, and most of the troops are already active in the Sandworm hatchery. Marcia's troops need help to finish the job and return quickly.
Sandworms and spiders are swarming the Queen landing lair.
The Sandworm Raid Group regularly carries out operations to reduce the sandworm population. Once these begin, all but essential members of the squad remain in the sandworm hatchery and only return when the mission is complete. The best and only way to get the squad members to come back is to help them complete their operation quickly.
I've been waiting. We've set so many traps for Queen Belandia, but with the luring device you brought... Okay, I must...
Marcia and her group had already set up a trap in the hopes of catching Queen Belandia. Unfortunately, it had proved useless, with the Queen never showing up at it. With the new luring device, however, she could be attracted to the trap and captured as planned. The place Marcia mentioned was filled with bombs and gunpowder chests, all meant to kill Queen Belandia. Even the fearsome beast would struggle to survive if caught there during the blast. The luring device was installed in a chest, placed in the center of the trap.
You're back. If we press this button... There she is!
Hmm.
Finally!
After Marcia pressed the button on the remote switch, Queen Belandia charged. Her fierce attack was cut short when she stopped in the middle of the trap and took flight. Determined to bring her down, the raid group let fly every arrow they had. The enormous sandworm was engulfed in an explosion as the gunpowder chest caught fire, but managed to escape.
Because I am Marcia. Every time I felt discouraged by my father always wanted our family to live together. I'm going to rebuild our family home. A place with so many happy memories. So, if you see my father again, we will kill Queen Belandia. It is a monument.
Marcia succeeded in critically injuring Queen Belandia and felt confident that the next battle against her would be the last. When she learned all of this stemmed from her ghostly father's request, a stone engraved with the names of all those killed by Queen Belandia rests on one side of the camp. This memorial only honors the officially identified victims, so it is impossible to guess how many more fell prey to her over the years.
Oh, then I'd like to ask, thank you.
The picture that Marcia asked you to deliver to her brother was a sign of her deep and aching longing for her family. It showed her childhood home, where she and her siblings shared many good times with their father Glenn before he lost his leg. After slaying Queen Belandia, it is Marcia's dream to rebuild the house there. Queen Belandia, the invincible, the all-consuming. No one had ever even so much as scratched the fearsome beast. Enter the Order of the Swan, a small-time guild hired by the Resistance to help gather sandworm poison sacks. While the Resistance soldiers were mopping up the sandworms, they were suddenly dragged into the sand beneath their feet. One of the swans, Rowan, fell into the vortex. All at once, Queen Belandia reared up, writhing in pain. Rowan had morphed into a violet phoenix and burst free from Queen Belandia's carapace, freeing everyone trapped inside. To this day, the mere sight of a human touched with malvescence is enough to violently enrage the mighty beast. Humans only defeated Queen Belandia once in the past. Among those she devoured that day was Rowan, who possessed the power of a star fragment. Rowan transformed into an ethereal violet phoenix and burst through her tough carapace. This was the first time Queen Belandia experienced such pain, and she fled in surprise.